So children, here we are with the new session. This is session number 8. And what we are going to do in this session, as I informed you in the previous session, we will derive the formula to find curved surface area of frustum of cone, okay, as well as the volume. Of course, even the total surface area, okay? Yes. Before I proceed further to the derivation of that formula, we'll have to recall one concept of similar triangles, okay? Here's triangle ABC, all right? And there's a line L parallel to
BD,
let's say intersecting the two sides in two distinct points M and
N.
Then we have got five results, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Here 6.1, AM upon AB, AM upon
AB
is equal to AN upon
AC,
AC, AM upon corresponding, I think so, AM upon
BM.
If you talk about theorem 6.1, it is AM upon MB is equal to AN upon
AC.
Then from this result, we get two more results. Ye do deduce kar sakte hai isi se. And that is AM upon
AB
is equal to AN upon
AC.
Aapko AM aur AN ko maintain karna ho, to niche lana ho. And then adding what? Okay? The other one, bolo. BM upon
AB
is equal to NC upon
AC.
Alright. And then there are two more results. That is AM upon AB. AM upon
AB
is MN upon
AC.
Same way. This side. AN upon AC. AN upon
AC.
That is MN upon BC. Yaad aaya? Kuch yaad aaya? For this, we are using ye theorem 6.1 se milta hai. Ye usi se deduced result milta hai. Aur ye similarity of triangle se milta hai. Similarity of triangles. Abhi prove kar dete. This two are parallel. So this angle is equal to this angle. Reason? Similarly, this angle is equal to this angle. Reason? And if you don't want to take that, you may take this angle. Angle BAC and angle BAM is common angle. So by AA criterion, AMN corresponds to ABC is similarity by AA. So there you are. AM upon AB. AM upon
AB
is equal to MN upon BC. MN upon BC. AM upon AB is equal to MN upon
BC.
Achha. You can take AN. AN. So, yahan se milega AC. AN upon AC is equal to MN upon
BC.
Alright. So, we have just recalled this result because in our derivation, we'll need it. Okay? Fine. I'll draw the frustum of cone, but I'll show how we get frustum of cone from a
cone.
This is of course cone, right? I'm going to call its slant height as capital H. Its height as capital H. And its radius as capital R. All right. This is height. I put here. ये उसकी हाइट है, वर्टिकल हाइट. आई पुट इट हियर, करेक्ट. कैपिटल एच, कैपिटल एल एंड कैपिटल आर. नाउ व्हाट आई एम गोइंग टू डू टू गेट फर्स्ट ऑफ कॉर्न, आई एम गोइंग टू कट इट फ्रॉम समवेयर, बट दिस प्लेन हैज टू बी पैरेलल टू दिस. ऑलराइट, आई गॉट टू पार्ट्स. व्हेन आई कट फर्स्ट ऑफ इनटू टू पार्ट्स आई गेट, व्हेन आई कट फर्स्ट ऑफ इनटू टू पार्ट्स आई गेट one part in the form of another cone, smaller cone, and the bottom part, the second part that you see is frustum. Ab mujhe uski curved surface area ko. So with respect to frustum of cone, please pay attention now. This is the height, h. Yahan se yahan, this is slant height. Yahan se yahan, aur yahan se yahan. ये रेडियस है और बड़ा है, सो कैपिटल आर ही रखेंगे और इसको स्मॉल. सो विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू फ्रस्टम ऑफ कॉर्न, दिस इज इट्स हाइट, वर्टिकल हाइट, दिस इज इट्स स्लैंट हाइट, दिस इज स्मॉल आर, एंड दिस इज बिकॉज फ्रस्टम ऑफ कॉर्न हैज टू रेडियस. ऑलराइट. और जो छोटा कॉर्न है, द टोटल हाइट इज, उसमें से इतनी हाइट, तो जो नया हाइट मिला उसकी हाइट होगी h माइनस. समझ में आ रहा है क्या? पूरा हाइट माइनस दिस. सेम वे पूरी स्लांट हाइट कितनी है? l. उसमें से फ्रस्टम का निकाल दो, सो यू विल गेट स्लांट हाइट l माइनस l. ऑलराइट, इज दैट क्लियर? नाउ देयर इज सिंपल लॉजिक टू फाइंड द कर्व्ड सरफेस एरिया ऑफ फ्रस्टम. Curved surface area of frustum of cone. What I'll do? First, I'll find total curved surface area of complete cone. From that, I'll cut the curved surface area of small cone. So, curved surface area of original cone minus curved surface area of new cone. The new cone is that first part. Are you getting me? Now what is the formula to find curved surface area of cone? Pi into radius into slant. If I talk about original, the radius is capital R and the slant height is? So pi R L minus. Okay? Now I'm talking about this cone. What is its radius? Okay, pi into radius small r. And slant height?
L minus small
l. L minus L. I'll have to put in the bracket. Okay. Ab dekho. When I'm talking about frustum of cone, there is capital R, frustum of cone se connected hai. Capital L, it's not connected to frustum of cone. Red small r, yes, it has some relation with frustum of cone. Capital L, no. Small l, wo to slant height hi hai. So the unwanted thing is capital L in this formula. Capital L has to do nothing with frustum of cone. So now I'll have to go for the substitution of capital
L.
Kahan se laye uski value? कहां से लाए उसकी बैग? नो दैट ओके. कैपिटल एल स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू कैपिटल एच स्क्वायर प्लस आर स्क्वायर, बट कैपिटल एच वो भी मुझे नहीं चाहिए. किसी ने कहा कि वी कैन टेक कैपिटल ये पूरा ओरिजिनल. ओके, लेट मी पुट योर नेम. दिस इज ए B, C, this is O, this is M, this is N, and let me put this P. So, kisi ne bola, a triangle A, O, C, AC square, that is L square, is equal to AO square, that is h square. Okay, that is h and r square. So I can write, I have substitution for l square, square root of. But वो h आया, वो तो आसमान से गिरे और खजूर पे अटके, वो h का क्या करेंगे? So we'll have to think differently. Please pay attention. Can you see some triangles? A, B, ये एक line होगी, ये vertical line है, और कोई भी दो slant height ले दो, तो you'll get one triangle in the same plane. Though this is three dimensional object, solid object, लेकिन ये center से जाने वाला एक diameter, और जो end point है वो top को join करो, and the vertical height, that is going to give you triangle A, B, C. Correct? और यहां से जो cut किया, वो डायमीटर इसको पैरेलल, यू गेट द डायमीटर और नॉट, कॉल इट एम एन एंड दैट सेंटर इज गोइंग टू पास थ्रू दिस वर्टिकल लाइन, सो यू गॉट अनदर ट्रायंगल ए एम, और मैंने कट ही पैरेलल किया है. सो इफ यू टॉक अबाउट दिस एंगल एंड दिस एंगल, दे आर इक्वल. इफ यू टॉक अबाउट दिस एंगल एंड दिस एंगल, दे आर
इक्वल.
व्हाई? बिकॉज दे आर corresponding pairs of angles. So if I talk about A, P, N, correspondence, kaunsa? A, triangle A, P, N.
A,
O, C. Alright, so here we are with the final example of exercise 13.4, the fifth one. Alright, and before that we derive the formula to find the curved surface area, total surface area and volume of frustum of cone. And I said we'll use that knowledge. But if we use that knowledge, this is going to be lengthy. The procedure of finding whatever is very lengthy. Alright. So instead, there's other way. And if we use trigonometry, yes, we can get the answer very quickly. Do you understand? So we won't use the similarity concept. We'll use trigonometry. Let's see how. Here is the statement. A metallic right circular cone 20 centimeter high. So we have a cone made up of metal and its height is
20
centimeter. And whose vertical angle is
60
degree. The angle at the top, okay, is 60 degree. Is cut, that metallic cone is cut into two parts at the middle of its height. Jo height hai. How much is the height? Exactly from the middle. We are cutting into two parts. Right? By a plane parallel to the base. So we have a plane parallel to base from where exactly we are cutting. Do you understand? So the original cone is divided into two parts. Are they equal parts because we are cutting from the middle? No, not equal. Volumes are not equal. Or even the shapes are not equal. The top part is going to be still cone. And the bottom part is what we call frustum of cone. Okay. If the frustum of cone so obtained, jo hame milega, by cutting that original cone into two, is drawn, obtained, be drawn into wire the diameter 1 upon 16 centimeter, find the length of the wire. Well, what concept are we going to use here? Children, that frustum of cone is melted and then it is turned into wire. So from one solid object, another solid object is prepared by the process of melting and cooling. Do you understand? What remains the same here?
Volume.
Yes, the shape may change, so surface area will change, but the volume will not change. So basic concept here is volume of frustum is equal to volume of wire, which is actually cylinder. Frustum of cone, the formula, 1/3 pi r square h, but that is r square plus r square plus r. And what is volume of cylinder?
Pi.
But now cylinder is a different thing. Okay, that pi is a different thing. So pi r square h. I'll put r1 and h. And this height of wire or cylinder is actually the length of
wire.
So this is what we are supposed to find. So what we need? Radius of wire. Not the radius, but diameter is given. So we can find the radius. So this is available. What else we need? The height of frustum of cone. It's not given. The height of cone is given. But exactly from the midway of vertical height. We divide it into two parts. The lower part is going to be the frustum. So what will be the height if we cut from the middle of 20 centimeter high?
10.
So this is not given, but then you get it from the data, from the information. Next we want is, yes, the two radii of the frustum of cone. Nothing is given about that. Kuch bhi nahi diya hai. So we'll have to find capital R and small r as well. Alright? Let's see how we can find that. So this is our target. Length of the wire. Radius we have indirectly from the diameter. Now this capital R and small r, they are still unknown. Nothing is told about it. Okay? About that. So we'll have to find it. Let's draw the figure and try to understand. Okay. Here is the original cone. Let's say A, B, C, and this is O. Its length is capital L. कहने की जरूरत नहीं है, फिर भी मैं कह रहा हूं. और this height is capital
H.
Now exactly from the middle. Now this is 20, you know, H is 20 centimeter. Exactly in the middle. So I'll take a midpoint of AO. Let me say that midpoint is P. So AP equal to PO, and that will be half of
20.
So that will be 10 centimeter. Now here, by a horizontal plane, yes, the original cone is cut into two parts. Now this is the frustum of cone. Isko kahenge small l, isko kahenge small h, that is already got, that is 10. Isko kahenge small
r.
Alright? Okay. Now how to find r and r? Kaise? Mera concept kuch aisa tha, ki isko l kaha gaya. So this is l minus l. Alright? Now this is h. Oh, this is obtained. 10, 10 and total 20. Alright? Now, to get r and r, you can use this Pythagoras. You can use Pythagoras, right? But that is going to be very lengthy. To get capital R and small r, going through this process, that is using the knowledge of similarity of triangles, all right, will be a very lengthy process. But we will use, and that idea we should get from the vertical angle that is given, right? This vertical angle is 60 degrees. So this is divided into two parts. 30 degree and 30 degree. Correct? Alright. So first, think of the right angle triangle in which R is involved. Are you getting me? Yeah. Small r is involved. So in triangle AP, let's say this is N, N, N. In triangle AP,
N.
PN is L. Angle A is 30. PA, that is known 10. So, with respect to angle 30, opposite side will have to involve. And adjacent side we can involve. So, opposite upon adjacent is?
10.
Ah, so, if I take 10, 30 is opposite side, which is R, upon adjacent side, which is 10. And 10, 30 is 1 upon root 3. That is R upon 10. So, cross multiplication, R is equal to 10 upon root 3. So, if you want, ऐसे ही रहने दो अभी. दिस इज आर. ऑलराइट, क्लियर? उसी तरह आई पिक अप ट्राइंगल ए ओ
सी.
उसमें एंगल ए इज 30 डिग्री, उसके सामने कैपिटल आर और एडजेसेंट साइड 20. सो यस, 10 30. यहां मैं ट्राइंगल लिख दू, ट्राइंगल ए पी एन, और ये है ट्राइंगल ए ओ सी. सो 10 30 opposite side, that is OC, I'll write R. upon adjacent side, that is AO, and that is 20. Once again, 10, 30 is 1 upon root 3, R upon 20. So R is equal to 20 upon root 3. So you got small r, you got capital R, and you got height. Yahi requirement thi hamari. Alright, okay. Chal. I'll just erase this part. Now I'll start my main work. Okay? Solution. Part. Frustum of cone. Now, first I'll just put the triangle. In triangle. Bolye, bolye. In triangle A, then A O C. P is mid, or straight away I can write, no? P is midpoint of OC or OA. P is midpoint of AO or OA. Therefore, PO is equal to AP is equal to half of AO. But AO is given, height is given. बोलिए बोलिए हाफ ऑफ 20 बाय डेटा देयरफॉर पीओ इज इक्वल टू पीए इफ आई वांट राइट इज इक्वल टू 10 रिजल्ट 1 सो दिस पीओ इज 10 एपी इज 10 एंड एओ इज 20 ऑलराइट अब मैं ट्रायंगल ले लूं इन ट्रायंगल एपीएन 10, 30 degree opposite side PN upon adjacent side AP. Here you may write PA. So 1 upon root 3, PN is how much? R. And AP is how much? Yeah, PA is how much? 10. Therefore, R is equal to 10 upon root 3. Result number 2. And in triangle AOC, well, here 10, 30 opposite side. ये ट्राइंगल में 10-30 ओपोजिट साइड OC अपॉन एडजेसेंट साइड AO 10-30 1 अपॉन रूट 3 OC कैपिटल R AO 20 देयरफॉर कैपिटल R इज इक्वल टू 20 अपॉन रूट 3 रिजल्ट नंबर 3 इज दैट ओके सो यू गॉट एवरीथिंग यू नीड हां एक और चीज अब लिखना है क्या डायामीटर डी वन क्या टाइटल दे दो क्या टाइटल दे दो वाई ओके डायामीटर इज 1 अपॉन 16 सेंटीमीटर देयरफॉर रेडियस इज इक्वल टू 1 अपॉन 16 डिवाइडेड बाय 2 दैट इज 1 अपॉन 16 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 1 अपॉन 2 कुछ बच्चे डायरेक्ट लिख दे 2 1 1 2 8 जा नाउ दिस बिकम्स 1 अपॉन 32 सेंटीमीटर इसको हम आर वन बोलेंगे देयरफॉर आर वन डायामीटर ऑफ Wire is 1 upon 16 centimeter. So radius is 1 upon 16 divided by 2. Converting division into multiplication. So that gives me 1 upon 32. So now everything is ready. So now, bolye bolye bolye, volume of frustum of cone is equal to volume of wire. Now I'm going to write the formula. Frustum of cone, 1/3 pi. बोलो आर स्क्वायर एच कैपिटल आर स्क्वायर प्लस स्मॉल आर स्क्वायर प्लस आर इंटू आर दैट इज इक्वल टू पाई आर स्क्वायर एच बट दैट विल बी वन एंड वन एंड दैट एच वन इज एक्चुअली द लेंथ ओके कैन आई इरेज दिस पार्ट यू नो द वैल्यूज ने वैल्यूज याद छे ने बोलो 1/3 आई थिंक पाई यू कैन कैंसल सो यू कैन कैंसल हियर ओनली टोटली प्रोडक्शन लेफ्ट हैंड साइड राइट हैंड साइड सो पाई कैंसिल सो 1/3 इनटू बोलो आर स्क्वायर कैपिटल आर स्क्वायर 400 अपॉन 3 प्लस स्मॉल आर स्क्वायर 100 अपॉन 3 प्लस 20 अपॉन रूट 3 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 10 अपॉन रूट 3 यू आर वेरी लकी इनटू एच एच इज हाउ मच 10 And that is equal to, bolye, R1, that is 1 upon 32. So 1 upon 32 into 1 upon 32 multiplied by 1. Chaliye, so this is 1/3 into, bolo, 4. Like denominator kar tu direct. Ye root 3 into root 3 will be 3. 3. So 400 plus 100 plus this will be 200. Theek hai? into 10 is equal to 1 upon 32 into 1 upon 32 multiplied by well, cancel तो नहीं हो रहा है. All right, तो decimal में आ रहा है answer. ये कुछ addition कमाल कर रहा है.
Decimal.
Okay, so ये addition भी कोई कमाल नहीं कर रहा है. नीचे 1 upon 9, ठीक है? 700, yes, कुछ नहीं कर रहा है. Into 10, into 32, that is equal to. कोई रास्ता नहीं. You have to multiply 32 into 32.
1024.
069. 4 or 6. 1024. Or multiply by 7. 1024 multiply by 7. 28, 2, 14, 16, 1 and 7. So, therefore, H1, height of that wire, that is how much? 1. 7168 and how many zeros? 1, 2, 3 divided by
9.
All right, divide the look. Divide by 9, 7, 63. So 86. 9 9s are 81, 5. Bring down 8. 9 6s are 54, 4. Bring down 0. So 9 4s are 36, 4 0. Bring down 0. 4s are 36, 4. Bring down the last 0. So 4s are 0.444 आने वाला है ना? So that is 7 9 6 4 4 4 0.44 centimeter. Now this is more than 1000. So convert into more than 100. So convert into and then more than 1000 meter are you to convert into kilometer. So first I'll convert into meter. 1 meter is 100 centimeters. So two places of decimal. 7964.4444. Kya ho gaya?
Meter.
Now again this is more than 1000. More than 1000. So move three places of decimal. 7.964444 kilometer. So that is around 7.964 kilometer. Okay, standard unit में आप छोड़ देंगे कोई बात नहीं. But if standard unit meter है length का, so if you want to leave in the answer in terms of meter, it's okay. हाँ, if it was asked in the question, they find the length of the wire in kilometers. Then it was necessary, otherwise the standard unit of length is meter. So you can keep it in the form of meter. That's all. So that is how you can find this. Alright, I hope you have understood. So that's all in this session. See you in the next session. Till then, goodbye. Have a nice day.
Stay safe.